Meredith, as Jack mentioned, we've seen one pretty good outing from Kluber. Last time a little uneven, so what are the expectations today?
Well, they're really hoping that he builds off that first start and forgets the second one. I actually spoke to Corey Kluber about his second start of the season yesterday, where he lasted just 2 1/3 innings, and he said that he felt as though it was just that one inning that got away from him and he didn't handle well. Aside from that, he felt as though his stuff was really moving in the right direction. He went on to say that it's very easy this early in the season to get too high or too low, but overall, he thinks as though he's certainly starting to feel better on the mound. Now, Matt Blake was in the Zoom room earlier today, and I asked him how he felt about Corey Kluber's first two outings.
And we've seen the calming presence out there of Corey, just as we know him as the stoic personality. I think he hasn't necessarily been as crisp as he would like, and I think that there's some delivery stuff we're working through a little bit just to kind of make sure we're all on the same page about what that looks like when he's at his best. And I think just getting back to an attack mindset now that he's competing again, I think that's the biggest thing, and just getting him comfortable competing in real games. And I think that's where we're just getting back into the flow of that a little bit.
With the exception of Gerrit Cole, the starters have not gone particularly long in games. How do you manage building guys up like Corey Kluber and Jameson Taillon while needing to not rely so heavily on the bullpen at the same time?
Yeah, it's a delicate balance. It's something we've talked a lot about in the preseason as an organization of, how do we want to prioritize these innings? Obviously, we've got a lot of question marks and just in general about the durability of the rotation given the last couple of years. So, the onus was on protecting the pitch counts early on for them. But obviously, on the backside of that, you don't want to overexpose the bullpen. It's a long season for them, too. So I think early on, with the starters being held to some pitch counts that was by design, and then there's some long innings involved there. I think, we've probably gotten the bullpen more work than we ideally would like. But I think it's something we're well aware of. And I think we got to, as the turns keep coming around, the pitchers will keep getting built up and pull back on some of the bullpen innings. So I think that's where having some of those length guys, whether it's Nelson, Sessa, Licky, Lowe, all kind of carry some of the burden there to protect some of the more traditional one-inning guys in those situations.
And then just back to Kluber, understanding it is early, it's a small sample size, but just from your vantage point, how close does he look to returning to that old form when he was a Cy Young Award winner?
Yeah, it's something we talked a lot about, especially coming out of the last one where it was a frustrating outing. It didn't go the way he liked. And I think just when we pull back and kind of take a breath and look at the outing as a whole, there wasn't a lot of hard contact. The pitch shapes were in a good spot. I think he was aggressive early, maybe got a little bit too fine, deeper into the count against certain hitters, and that elongated some of those at-bats. So I think just getting closer to that attack mindset and just being aggressive over the plate, I think that's for him is where we're going to get to over these next couple starts.